There are plenty of videos out on YouTube that explain the anatomy of an acoustic bicycle. But today, we're going to go over what makes an electric bicycle an electric bike. That's right, we're talking about the anatomy of an electric bike. So let's start off with the most important part of an electric bike, the drive unit. So there are many drive units out on the market. We typically sell bicycles that are equipped with the Bosch, Yamaha, Shimano, or Brose motors. Sometimes you'll hear that these electric bikes have engines, but that is incorrect. There is no combustion within these motors. So your drive unit is either called the drive unit or a motor. So what powers the drive unit? A battery. So most bicycles that we sell typically come with a minimum 400 watt hour battery packs and can skyrocket up to dual 625 watt hour battery packs. And these days, you should only be looking for bicycles that are equipped with lithium ion batteries. Nickel metal hydride or lead acid batteries are a no-go. So how do you turn on these systems? Most of the time, you can press the power button on the battery, but if you don't have that, your bicycle is most likely equipped with a display with the power button. Working in tandem with your display is your remote, and in some cases, they are combined, like the Bosch Purion display. Some displays have a lot more user functions than others, and some are pretty minimal. Some are so minimal that there isn't a display at all. But you'll always have a remote system that allows you to engage the different power levels of your system. Another important part of your e-bike system that is commonly overlooked is the speed sensor. The speed sensor works in combination with a speed sensor magnet, which can be located on your spoke or on the brake rotor itself. It's important to know where that speed sensor magnet is located on your bike, because if it gets knocked out of place and not aligned with that speed sensor, it could prevent your e-bike from working properly. We've had a few panic calls in the past where customers think that their e-bikes are broken, when in true reality, it was just the speed sensor magnet that was misaligned. Because these bikes are battery powered, many manufacturers take advantage of this and install integrated lights. So you might see integrated headlights and rear lights on your bike. So that's the anatomy of a current electric bicycle out on the market. But what does the future hold? Well, Bosch and Magura are currently working on some ABS, or anti-lock braking systems, that can be equipped with electric bicycles in the very near future. There's also more and more electric shifting systems being developed every year, and pretty soon they'll all be integrated to that same electric bike system. To keep up to date to the newest editions of the electric bicycle, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video if you found it useful. Until next time, my name is Hector. Enjoy the ride.